I heard my next opponent used to make burgers. I heard my next opponent used to make burgers. I heard my next opponent used to make burgers.
The Untouchable True School Sports Empire proudly presents Something the Boxing Game's Been Missing. Hey, what's going on? It's your boy BT, and I came here to talk some boxing with the thousands of True School Sports subscribers. Now, make sure you guys hit that like button and definitely take the time to subscribe, and all that will be greatly appreciated as always. Listen, man, I gotta tell you, man, that out of all the unification fights that can be made in boxing, this one for me is right towards the top of the list. I really do want to see this fight. And I want to see it next. I don't really think either one of these fighters have any time to waste. As you guys can see at the beginning of the video, Mairis Breidis doesn't want to waste no time. Mairis Breidis versus Lawrence Okolie. That's the next fight. That's the fight that we got to see to determine who truly is, at this juncture in time, the best cruiserweight in the world, the number one cruiserweight in the world. Because I would venture to say, you know, Breidis is the best cruiserweight in the world. You know, he's a lineal champion. He's a Ring Magazine champion. He beat Junior Ticos, he's beating Glavacki, he's beating Marco Hug, he's got a great resume. He's been in the ring with Alexander Usyk. You know, didn't win him, didn't beat him, but Mairis Breidis is probably one of the most underrated world champions in boxing right now. And Lawrence Okolie is a guy that, you know, when we look at him, he's conquered British level, European level. You know, he beat my boy Isaac Chamberlain in one of the worst fights of all time. You know, he's stepped up and beat Glavacki, knocked him spark out for the world title. And he's just shown fight by fight that he's getting better and that he's a serious threat in the cruiserweight division. But we don't know. We know he's good. We know he's world champion. But just how good is Lawrence Okolie? How far can he go? Can he be the undisputed cruiserweight champion of the world and throw his name into the hat of the cruiserweight undisputed champions of yesteryear? You know, can he do that? We're gonna see, man. The British boxing has a long tradition of dominating this weight class, and Lawrence Okolie, I feel like he's got a unique opportunity here. You know, Mairis Breidis fought Artur Mann yesterday, knocked out, beat Artur Mann. I don't know if he knocked him out or got a UD, but I know he beat him. And he called him straight away. Mairis Breidis has never been a fighter to duck no smoke. This is the same guy that fought Usyk, Dorticos, Glavacki, Marco Huck. He's fought the who's who of the cruiserweight division. And he's not no spring chicken. He's not exactly a young guy. He's 36 years old, so he don't got much time left. And he's looking to make the biggest fights and the best fights happen possible. And I really feel like if and when the fight does happen, it'll be the true litmus test for Lawrence Okolie, because Mairis Breidis is a good fighter. Breidis can box, he can punch, he can slug. He's been in dog fights, he's won dog fights, he's been in all kinds of fights. And I really think that Breidis is going to be someone that's going to take that's capable. He fights to the best of his abilities. He's capable of taking Okolie to deep, dark, uncomfortable places that Okolie has not yet gone to in his boxing career. And that's the intriguing thing about that fight. So, like, look, I know Eddie Hearn has big plans for Okolie. Okolie's a big cruiserweight, significantly bigger than Breidis. Okolie's the kind of fighter that I could see being cruiserweight champion, being bridgerweight champion, and then eventually going up and making some noise at heavyweight later on in his career, because he's got that kind of frame, he's got that kind of size, and he's got that kind of skill. I think so. So we're going to see what happens to Lawrence Okolie, but this is the fight that needs to happen. If Lawrence Okolie truly is who he says he is, and if he's worth his salt as a cruiserweight, and he's worth his salt as a fighter in this sport of boxing, he got to be fighting Mairis Breidis next, because Breidis is, there really is, like, I know right now you got Lalongo Makabu, who I'm a big fan of. You got him as a champion, and then you got Breidis as a champion, and I don't know if I'm missing anybody else, but, you know, I would say Breidis right now is easily, out of all the champions he could fight at cruiserweight, he's the best name he can get on his resume. And once he beats him, he's now a lineal champion. He's now a ring, if he can beat him, he's a Ring Magazine champion. And Lawrence Okolie is the man at cruiserweight. He's the guy. He's someone that we gotta look at in a different light if he beats Mairis Breidis. Now, credit to Okolie, he's gotten to a place in his career where he's become a world champion. He's knocked out someone like Glavacki, but beating a guy like Breidis takes him to the next level. And I think it'd be a good test of Okolie's physical strength. It would be a good test of his boxing skills. It would be a good test of how he uses that size. It would be a good test of his command of distance. It's just going to be a good test all around, because we've seen when Mairis Breidis come hella high water. You know, he gave Usyk a good account of himself. He beat the shit and outclassed the KO doctor, which I thought was a really good performance from him. you know, beat him. He had that fight where it was just absolute mayhem in Riga, Latvia, with Christoph Blavatsky. You know, there was a lot of crazy things happening in that fight, but hey, he won that fight. Can't take that from him. So I want to see this fight. There is no other fight in the cruiserweight division. There is no other fight that truly matters as far as unification fights go in this division, probably more than this one. So look, man, it's in 2022. It's the year of no excuses. It's the year of no dishonor. We got to put these fights together. We got to press for these fights to happen, because we can't have four champions. We can't have four guys who we all see in this weight class that are saying they're the best. No. We got to get to the nitty gritty and get to the core of everything. Who is the best fighter at cruiserweight? Who is the best fighter in this weight class? You know, Okolie can't be over here saying he's the best, and Breidis can't be saying he's the best, and Makabu can't be saying he's the best. These guys got to all fight each other. And I really feel like, you know, in this division, the most sensible and logical fight next is this fight. So, yeah, man, I want to see this fight next. I'm looking at this as a true legacy fight for the career of Breidis and Okolie, because for Breidis, he beats Okolie. That just adds to the resume of what's already a fantastic cruiserweight resume. You know, Breidis, when he hangs up his boxing gloves, not only will he go down as probably the greatest Latvian boxer of all time, but he will also go down as one of the better cruiserweights in history. His history will remember Mairis Breidis very fondly as one of the best cruiserweights of all time, maybe even one of the top 10 best cruiserweights of all time. So I'm looking at this to be, you know, potentially the finishing touch of what's been a remarkable career in the sport of boxing for him. He's done a great job carrying boxing for his country, wrapping the flag high for Latvia. And for Okolie, you know, this could be the start of something truly great for him if he beats Breidis, because now he's beaten the best guy and become Ring Magazine champion. And listen, once you become a Ring Magazine champion, for the most part, you know, once you touch a Ring Magazine belt in boxing, that's when you truly arrive and you truly become a real champion. And that's when you truly, you know, stated your claim as the best in your weight class, because they don't just give those out. You don't win those because the sanctioning body mandated you to fight the number 7 guy. You know, you don't win them by circumstances. You win them by fighting someone who was of great enough quality to get that belt. So, yeah, make this shit happen, man. Breidis versus Okolie. We got to see this happen in 2022. So, yeah, man, you leave your comments down below. Who are you guys favoring and why? Leave your comments down below. Make sure you take the time to subscribe. And like I say in every single one of these videos, you can love me or you can hate me. But I'm just kidding, Daniel. So until next time, take care, guys.